As an artist, your main goal is to touch people.
From the day I went away.
The moment I realized that I came here with a purpose, I have this gift, and I can actually achieve something. I have a goal. That's when music came into my life. When I get ready for a performance, I transform myself, the whole putting on the makeup, putting on a suit, and that journey that start taking you into Frankenfurter. There's a lot of layers before you actually are there.
Come on, baby. Show you around, baby. Play yourself. You look like you're both pretty groovy. But if you want something visual, that's not to a bit more. We could take it in all.
Riches is a gay nightclub here in Houston. The manager saw Rocky Horror and he was very interested in seeing me perform. I couldn't drive because I had on my heels, so my niece, Soraya, had to drive. I'm sitting down next to her and I'm nervous, of course, because she's driving. I still see her as a little girl, which she's not. It's really hard for me to be a passenger.
But I turn on the light,
the car lights. The car is automatic, babe.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, you have no gas, you're on 1 mile.
Then of course I realized that we had to tank. So I went out and I tanked. The store owner, he was just looking at us and thinking, what is happening? And I was hoping that he wasn't gonna call the police. Of course he wasn't gonna call the police. We paid. I was supposed to be there at 11:30. It's now 12. Well, it's not bad. So I came to the club and I had to run to the dressing room and then they called my name. I was so nervous.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a hobby sitter, he did Rocky Horror this year.
There was a bare stage. Everybody was standing far away from me. But as I started to sing, I saw that the people were interacting.
I see you shiver with anticipation. The same time.
It was fun. And then I really stepped out of myself and just play, entertain, just be. I grew up in Port-au-Prince, Haiti, in a very conservative Haitian family. I came to America when I was 9 years old. That's the first time I saw my mother. That was more important. That was more in my mind than America. I grew up in a house full of girls. I would play with heels or girls' things, like, you know. I didn't really have a notion that I wanted to be female or male. It wasn't in my mind. It was just something to play with. But what intrigued me, that I would get punished for playing with these things. So then you start to hide it. Then you start going further away from who you are. Music made me different. It kind of gave me a place where, for me to be myself. When I was 17, I got an audition for Gloria Estefan in Tokyo Disneyland. So that was my first job at 17 years old. I was living abroad in Japan. Then I got a role in Hair that brought me over to Holland. Rent in Germany, from Aida all the way to Zurich, where I did my first drag audition for La Cage aux Folles. I was always playing these masculine, tough roles because, you know. So I remember the audition. The director asked me, okay, so I want you to do this role and do the lines. So I did it and I was a bit too masculine. So he told me, think of RuPaul and do it again. I was like, oh, that's what you want. Okay. Then I went out and then I came in and then I did it. And he was just like, okay, got it. Fine. Perfect. Thank you. And then I got the job. The little boy who was playing in heels came out for the first time in drag in a performance in front of a huge audience 6 years ago. And that was hard for me. It was hard for me, yeah. Yeah. Because it was almost like the little boy was accepted. Oh, I genuinely cry. It's not about the woman's clothes. It's just that the first time that little boy was not accepted was because of those clothes. And for the first time, he was accepted again. So that wound was finally healed. Yeah.
It's astounding.
The main connection between Frankenfurter and Pierre Alexander is that we both have this house where they can express themselves. Go out of what society expects you to be. When you come in, you see there's a stage, and the previous owner, he designed the house in acoustic to have live performances. The moment I came into the house for the first time, I just knew that this was almost built for me. The house found me. The moment I really realized that this was for me is that there was this octagon room, which I felt like the heart of the house. And I knew that that was my meditation room. When I have issues or problems, this is kind of my prayer room. For me, spirituality means the study of self. The sage is an old Indian ritual to get rid of negative energy. Harry B. Happy, he's a Buddhist monk, and he plays the crystal bowls. So the vibration of the crystal bowl or the gong connects with the water in your body. Just clear up your chakra. So it's a cleaning tool. So it's the same thing as I'm using the sage. They just break the negative energy in the air that is stored in the air. Because everyone come here. And it's a great place for your negative energy to just stay here. Unfortunately, I have to live here, so it's good to get rid of it. And so keep the place clean. Maison Blanche works as a creative safe haven for many artists, visual artists, performing artists, designers. They all come here because it just has that safe environment to support their creativity. One of the first artists that came here was Lee Arnett. He did this beautiful mural that is actually inspired by Keith Haring with a little bit of Haitian teas in it. But I've also connected this house with friends of mine. They wanted to do photo shoot in Mermaid's Tales. And she wanted to come with her daughter. And I found that this house also gave her that safety and for her to express herself.
As the words fade away, I still believe what your eyes say.
I also use this house as a charity-based event, and also do a lot of events like Studio 54 or intimate events like salons. Last night, we had a salon here. Mary Griffin came. She blessed us with two beautiful songs, Straight from the Heart. And I had a visual performance. My body painted was inspired by Keith Haring.
Oh, I sing! Oh, blue skies through the tears in my eyes. And I realize I'm going.
What I want to achieve I think that RuPaul made this art form as drag very mainstream, and I think it's up to us, or me, to bring this into people's life.
I'm going.